just talk us through. We'd all been waiting with bated breath as to ultimately how Apple adopts AI.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. So 2024, it's the year of AI for Apple, generative AI and large language models, to be specific. The company is working on several new artificial intelligence initiatives to run on both the iPhone and the Mac. And one of the most important things is setting your sort of infrastructure and foundation to integrate AI into your products. And the most core thing you can do is add artificial intelligence to your programming right. tools. That's Xcode. That's the software used by developers inside Apple and outside Apple. So they'll be adding AI to that.
I'm really interested, Mark, on the pressure that Craig Federighi is under, because if you read the detail in your story, which is terrific, by the way, you know, the board was given a demo of the latest in AI at the end of last year, and they've almost reorged. They basically said, you three key personnel, give us the product.
Yeah, Craig Federighi, he's Apple's Senior Vice President of Software Engineering. He's really taken the bull by the horn here. He's a huge proponent of LLMs and generative AI. When ChatGPT started to hit the market a couple of years ago, he was the one really pushing and investigating, is Apple going to miss out on this technology? Does Apple need to integrate this technology? And so Federighi, along with Apple's cloud services organization, as well as the artificial intelligence organization, right, run by Eddie Q and John Gian Andrea specifically, those three groups have been working together on these Gen AI initiatives, with Federighi implementing it into iOS. Right. The Gen AI, the underlying technology, is obviously developed by Apple's AI group, but it's Federighi who's consumerizing that technology, and they plan to release that as part of iOS 18 this year, which I expect to be one of the biggest updates, if not the most significant update in the 16-year history of the iPhone.